What's up, everybody? It's your boy VP here chilling here with Prez because of Brian. God
damn. You ain't like that,
about to blow out my ears.
Gotta keep the energy. We're here reviewing our first anime. What's the name of this show?
Fire Force.
No, the show on YouTube.
Oh, shoot. We're recording our first episode of Tal to be determined later.
That's our long title just for an anime review.
Today we watched, it was Fire Force.
Yep. First episode dropped on Friday.
First episode dropped on Friday, like Prez said, and we're going to talk about it. We just got done watching it. I thought it was cool.
All right, how about we just start from the beginning, okay? So, as far as the beginning of the show, we saw someone just light up on fire from their cigarette, turn into this demon.
He wasn't even smoking. Yo, I ain't gonna lie, that was the best part of the show.
Yeah, that was the best part. I was like,
just people on the train. Like,
I legitimately thought he was like smoking a cigarette and the cigarette lit up.
Nope. The demon came out of him, you know what I mean?
He said later on, that was just spontaneous
combustion. What kind of issue is that to have in a world where you just gotta worry about just burning up for no reason?
Yeah, for no reason.
Not even that, just burn up and turn into a demon that kills you.
Yeah.
And it can just happen to anybody. Anytime.
And this is clearly, everyone knows it's from the Soul Eater team, and it clearly has a lot of that influence in there, like from the get-go,
yes,
up to the character design and everything.
Not the main character with spiky teeth.
Yeah. True!
Yeah, just like Soul. He looks a lot like Soul. Red eyes and everything, too.
And the name of their god is Soul, too.
Oh, yeah, their name's... Soul Eater is his full name. Yeah. Well, so what do you guys think about the main character?
He was generic. Very generic.
That's the thing. His backstory was split up. Like, we saw glimpse, like, throughout the episode. When we first saw the first glimpse, and it was like, I want to be a hero, Mom. The first thing I said out loud was, that's really generic as far as the backstory goes.
Yeah. We weren't really given any hint to his motivation at all for most of the episode.
Right, but it was pretty easy to figure out after, like, you found out the state of the world.
I mean, I want to talk about, like, the overall design of him. I don't know what it is about these animes. I kind of have mixed feeling when it comes to the main character not looking like a good guy. You know what I'm saying? Like, you look at him, it's like, when I first saw him, the first thing I said was main character alert. Now look at him, like, this dude look like a villain right here.
Well, that's the point. That's part of the backstory.
That kind of seems like a cliche at this point.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I said I have a mixed feeling of it. Now, when it's done correctly, you know, it's cool. You know what I'm saying? It's just not many of them have done it correctly.
That's why I like Saitama, because he's bland.
Yeah!
He's
bland as hell.
But as far as Fire Force goes, that fan service came in real quick.
Yeah.
Out of nowhere. I ain't mad at it.
I mean, unpopular opinion, I don't like that shit.
I think it came in too fast.
Because I'm like, I feel like it cheapens what the show could be.
But for the most part, it was only one scene.
What? That's one episode. Watch. And in the shower.
And like half the ending.
Yeah. They've been sitting there with a t-shirt on and just throws water herself for no reason.
We gotta get through the rest of the show before we talk about the ending.
Okay. So yeah, Shinra, as far as the character goes, the part I found interesting was his like smile thing going on.
You know what? I hate that too. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Really? Well, what bothers you about that?
Is that I know that guy or the team who makes Soul Eater, they like that smile. You could tell because when you watch
it,
Soul
looked
Eater,
like a Soul Eater smile.
Soul smiles a lot. They all, anybody with sharp teeth, they smile a lot. So I could tell they wanted to have a reason to implement it in this show. And it just seems kind of tacked on and kind of ridiculous to me personally. It just seemed like,
that's a fair
weird
way to look at it. But for me, it's more like it looks like he got framed. Like, well, that's actually a question I have. So his mother, this is a lot of spoilers. Spoilers will be in the title of the episode. His mother ends up like becoming one of those infernals. It looks like, right?
He
said one popped out and just killed both of them.
He said other than his mother. So I
there was some, that's what he's saying. Something was there.
Right.
She was just on fire.
Yeah.
She didn't combust.
I like the way that I thought I understood it was that she became one of those
infernals.
Well, why was she talking?
Because, like, I don't know.
So
like,
far, none of them been talking.
But we also have only seen two.
I mean, still, but that's all I have to go off
can,
of.
Can I say what I was trying to say?
We wasn't done.
Yeah, we wasn't
okay. I got a theory.
Okay, what's your theory? What's
first,
your theory?
You go first, though.
Fine, I'll go first.
Of course you go take
this is Prez. but, Prez. No, here's my thing. When we saw him in the backstory, we saw a Fire Force agent with him holding his hand as a kid. Mm-hmm. So clearly an Infernal had to be involved at some point, right? Like, these aren't firefighters. These are Fire Force. They're specialized in the Infernals. So that's my thing. If there's a Fire Force guy there, there's clearly an Infernal involved, but still everyone's blaming the kid.
Right. Because he's a Generation 3 Infernal. He's technically an Infernal.
Is that how it goes? Yeah. Like, he's an Infernal?
Yeah. He can spontaneously create fire.
Theory. What was your theory, VP?
Well, my theory is, and it's quite, to me, it was kind of crystal clear because he saw that little demon face. Something broke in his house and killed his mom and brother. That's what happened. And because he's a Generation 3, I think it was already pre-established that he was a Generation 3, so they just blamed him. Which, outside looking in,
looks like him, yeah.
And that's where I like how the smile plays in there, because he's always smiling after seeing this scene. I can kind of see people being like, okay, that's really, really suspicious.
Yeah.
And then another
thing is... The grandma's bad, though. That grandma was bad.
Yeah. And then another thing is, it kind of gives him... I don't like this per se, but it kind of gives him like a revenge arc, a little thing, because he saw what it was. He saw something was there.
Yeah.
So he knows that something did this.
Yeah.
My theory is it's probably dad.
We didn't see anything about his dad, so it could be.
That's what I think.
But you know, in a lot of these animes, I don't know what it is.
It'd be the dad.
Single moms, bro.
Exactly.
They don't. Dad don't be
here's
there.
A question for you guys.
Wait,
how much you guys want to bet?
Child of death.
How much you guys want to bet that the brother's alive and is gonna hate him?
He said it was. Oh, yeah, because they said they couldn't even find his body.
Even the bones are gone.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like, what if the brother's alive and like he's gonna hate him?
That's generic.
Yeah,
that's very generic.
That's the thing though. This show, animation wise, I really like the animation style when he's using the fire and everything. I thought that was really clean. But at the same time, so far as the story goes, it seems a little predictable.
Well, here's the thing though.
It seems very tropey. Brian was actually saying that earlier.
We only watched the first episode, and I have a rule now that I try not to judge these animes on the first episode, because I, when I first watched Gurren Lagann, I hated that show based off the first episode.
That took me a minute to get
into. I thought it was garbage. Mm-hmm. I really did. And now, you know.
Yeah, you were in the drill right now.
Drill, you know what I'm saying? One of my favorite animes. I'm kind of anticipating. I'm kind of looking forward to the next episode, because I want to see where they go from here, you know. I also want to know how his power is. Is there any growth
that he can have as a power?
Because he looks OP world.
Yeah, he really does.
And then I also want to know, like, what are all the minute differences between the different generations of pyrokinetics?
Well, that's the thing. It seems like the people that were already there, the two girls, the nun and the other chick, Maki, I think her name was. They seem to be previous generations because he can generate fire, but Maki seems to push it away. She's a pyrokinetic.
Nun doesn't have powers. They said that, like, in that little announcement.
Yeah, she's just there to give.
For everyone that likes to skip openings and endings in shows, watch the ending in the show. It's basically the nun's backstory. I mean, the point is, I'm saying, like, at least for first episode, folks, watch that ending.
Yeah, it gives you a lot of stuff to kind of go off of.
Yeah, yeah, except even though it is, like, that in-your-face etchy again real fast.
Yeah.
Like, here's my problem. Like, I'm fine with fan service, but this was the first episode. And the first episode for any show sets the tone and is supposed to be what draws you in.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like adding fan service that quick kind of, like Brian said, almost cheapens it a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you can tell their main focus is probably going to be the action.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's
what you're here that for. Animation you're not here for the story like
and that. While we're talking about the action, the one thing that we all agreed on was when he first used his power.
Oh, my.
There was, like, no distance between him and the enemy, but it looked like he was going for miles.
It wasn't an enemy. A thing was going to fall on a nun, and it took him ages. She would have got hit by the time he got there.
Like,
it took him so long.
Like, go back and look at that scene where he's, like,
cool
saving
scene.
The nun.
Cool
it, it's really well animated, but when you look at the distance, you're like, this should be, like, a two-second thing.
Because he was, like, right there. He's like...
He could have walked over and just pushed down the
and then when he's fighting the Infernal near the end of the episode, same deal. Because we had a, like, shot of them, like, face-to-face, maybe 10, 15 feet away.
Yeah.
And then he's doing all this crazy stuff. I want to believe that that's because he was also dodging and stuff. Because there was more movement going on. I believe
that's what it appeared to be like. They were in the middle of the fight, so it's all the maneuvering.
But it still seems like distance is very exaggerated.
Yeah. I like that. I like the build-up, though, for him to finally use his power. I was waiting for it.
Oh, that's another position thing, too.
It was like, going Super Saiyan for a second.
That's another thing these kind of anime suffer from, because I feel like he went through, like, a whole arc in one episode.
True.
That shit was rushed like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
But that makes you question, like, what's the actual show overall going to be like?
Yeah, but I'm like, the payoff could have been better with that.
Because you know what's crazy? It made me think of Blue Exorcist.
That's the thing. I get a lot of Blue Exorcist vibes. Yeah. I don't know. Do you guys know if Soul Eater also did Blue Exorcist? Like, is that the same team?
We'll have to check that out. But I got a lot of Blue Exorcist vibe. Like, the whole... Kind of like his backstory, too. Kind of like he's something, you know...
But that Blue Exorcist execution on that first episode was way better.
That's what I'm saying. But that's because they took time to establish, like, kind of their background and their father figure a little
bit. You're right. That was three episodes in, actually, when that happened.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I feel like this episode should have been the first three. They should have...
Space it out,
maybe give him a little more time with his team.
I think that's why I don't like this anime, because I don't like Blue Exorcist.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't like that.
Well, here's my theory. I think maybe they didn't want you to focus too much on this character, like his backstory and stuff. They're like, we just want to get this out of the way, because the story to come is more important. We're going to spread that out more.
I don't know.
Like, establish him and start moving.
For that to be the case, he'd have to be an interesting main character. Hopefully he do something to really... That'd make him stand out.
Right.
I would have rather anime like this be more about the team than the main character.
Yeah, Sam.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's so obviously, like, way more OP than everybody else. Does he even really need them, like, to be honest?
That's what I think they need to expand on. Because he did allude to, you know, the teamwork and calmness.
Right.
Saves more life than heroics. So I'm thinking maybe later on something might happen.
As far as the team goes, like, the one question I asked you guys before was, is the nun's whole purpose just to pray for these people they're murdering?
So my thing about the nun is, so my overall theory of this thing, they're talking about they need to figure out what is causing this. I think it's obviously demons of some sorts. So that's what screams to me. That's why it feels like Blue Exorcist. And she's there to help the soul get to the afterlife, you know, move on. And they literally said they save souls.
Right.
Because it seems like They just have no remnants of what they are, but the soul is still trapped there. That's why they're still alive and still moving and shit. You know what I'm saying? So they gotta kill it, but then save the soul. You know what I'm saying? Right. It seems like this society has a lot of religious undertones, and I'm kind of interested to see how the rest of the world is. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, the world.
They live in a chapel.
Yeah, that's weird.
In a cathedral.
Yeah.
You know, that's where they live.
So one thing that you point out, like, right away when the show opened up, is the city looks a lot like Legend of Korra.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a lot like that.
Yeah. Very, what would you call it? Like, steampunk?
Maybe.
Not really steampunk too much, but...
Just steam. Technology, I guess.
I kind of get where you're coming from.
So that's my... I think the purpose of the nun there is just basically for the benefit of the demon they're fighting, because they don't necessarily see them as, oh, this is an evil thing, we have to kill it. They see it as, this is a tortured soul that needs help getting onto the afterlife. That's why her importance is there.
Right. You know what I'm saying? And there's clearly other characters we haven't met yet because of the opening that we saw.
Yeah.
Like, there's that chick with the fire cat stuff going on.
Yeah.
Maybe that'd just be another addition.
I want to know who's the Fire Force guy that was with the main character when he was a kid.
Yeah. Like, the one holding his hand when he was being accused.
I wonder, will they even touch on that, or is he just like a generic guy?
Watch him be the main villain.
I know that's not the case. I want them to. That's what I'm saying. I want them to kind of expand more on his backstory, because from what we got here, it's very generic. And I'm hoping later down the line, you know, we'll see these little differences and more complexity to it.
So I think that's the one thing we can all agree on. The big drawback right now is how generic everything seems to be.
Mm-hmm.
The standout points are the concept is interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very interesting.
Like the firefighting demon in human combustion, that's all brand new. I like it. I'm interested. And the animation for the combat, that's very clean.
Yeah, very crisp.
At least to me, it's not so much that, like, his backstory and that is so generic, because most of the time, cliche generic things can be done well. It's just, like, to me, the execution of it was kind of lackluster, so that's why it seems like the bad type of genetic.
Because when I first saw it, I thought he was the cause. I thought he killed his mom and sister. I actually would have liked that more than what we got. You know, instead of the whole, this demon broke house. Oh, no, I'm a monster. I would have preferred that.
I had a similar theory to you where I was like, all right, I think they became Infernals.
Yeah.
But then I thought he put them down as Infernals. And that's how his power awakened.
Oh, as a kid, he's just like, oh, they died.
And kicked their hearts out.
Yeah.
Pretty much, they could have literally did anything besides what they did.
Yeah. I don't like the setup of a bad guy. I don't like that setup. This world doesn't need a main antagonist.
He even said that, too. He was like, I want to find out who did this. Like, it was a person. Like, I thought these were just mindless, you know, anomalies that happened.
I would have liked to see later down the line that maybe it is a demon causing it, like a big demon, but, you know, I would have liked it to be more like a natural phenomenon type thing. Like,
it's hard to deal with this.
Yeah, you know? but here they kind of already established, like, oh, there's people out there, things out there that can control these things. There's probably going to be other Generation 3s that are just evil.
The Fire Cat's probably Generation 3.
Yeah. So, yeah.
The girl opening, because that's she's looks like she's producing fire.
Yeah. And I don't necessarily like that. You know, I think that's probably gonna be like one in, like, depending on how long this anime goes, how much support it get. I could see that being like an arc later on line, like, oh, we gotta fight Generation 3s. Who knows what they're doing?
Generation 4s are to like take the stage.
Exactly.
Or it's gonna be revealed there's a generation that can control the Infernals. I'm like, oh, come on.
The opening was good.
And
the music was all pretty good.
That's what we mean by the opening.
Yeah, that's okay. I like how the vehicle is called the Matchbox. That's hilarious to me.
That was pretty ironic.
Yeah. It's like, I'll just...
So, what would you guys say your... Let's close off like this. What's your least favorite part about the first episode, favorite part about the episode, and what are you hoping to see?
So, my least favorite thing about the anime was how they kind of try to do too much of the backstory of the main character in the first episode. I think it kind of takes away from the overall flavor of the anime. If you're going to do a first episode, I think they should have just established the characters, established the world, show off, you know, the action, you know, what this story's about. They could have ended with maybe something hinting at his backstory that would kind of draw you in more and then go from there. But it was kind of like main character, main character, main character, and I'm just sitting like, I want to see them fight. You know, the whole time, like, I want to see them fight.
Yeah.
And what would you say your favorite part was of the episode?
Oh, the action. And the sound. The sound was awesome. Like, the sound of, like, the fire. Like
the overall sound
design. Yeah, it was really cool. It gets me excited to see the crazy stuff they're going to fight later on.
Yeah. So, and last thing, obviously, what you want to see later on? Like, what
fight more crazy stuff. I want to see... I would like to see how the character can grow, not just as, you know, development, but as power, because... That world, it seems like he's OP. So I want to see what else is there. What's the drawbacks? There don't seem like any drawbacks to this fire stuff.
All right. What about you, Brian? Least favorite, what you want to see?
I agree with
VP.
VP, thank you. About the whole, you know, them showing his backstory in the beginning. Because it's like the pacing of the first episode. I guess overall, that's the overall thing when it was the pacing. It was like way too much jam-packed into one episode where it could have been spread out better to better flesh it out, you know, especially like the backstory. I feel like that's very important because that's the reason your character is the way he is.
Right.
Know? That's important. So you should properly do that so it's, you know, properly felt. Especially because like something like you seeing your mom and your brother die, you know,
that's a big thing.
That's supposed to hit, you know, like, oof, man.
Apparently like burned to death too.
Yeah,
brutal.
Like that's one of the worst ways to die. When that junk happened, I'm sitting there stone faced. Like, I was like, that's tough. You know? That's tough.
Yeah, I kind of agree with you.
Yeah. You know, I just didn't feel anything. And as far as like what I liked,
the characters being ripped.
No. That was hilarious. Like, I guess the action, but in these animes, at least at this point in my life, you know, I want more than just action, especially because I've seen shows have the action and have the story.
Right.
But the action was good. I can't deny that. It was all the animation, beautiful sound, beautiful. All that stuff is good.
That's one that surprised me. The fact that sound was
I wasn't expecting like the hits when they hit. There was so much impact that they that weird
the little and, crisps to the flames and stuff.
Yeah, that was really
that's
nice.
That's attention to detail.
Yeah. And as far as the future of the show, I'm actually more interested in the world.
Okay.
And how that whole religion and how that whole thing gets expanded upon, because I don't understand. And it just seems kind of like vague right now. But I really want to know what all this is. Like, are we ever going to see this god soul, or is that going to play a part? Where do these souls go? You know, what, is there a place? Can we see it? Where's the opposite of that? What's hell? What is that?
Yeah. You know? To me, it just seems like a general monotheistic religion, and they're just trying one god religion, where they're just trying to give people some comfort with the idea of them murdering people.
Yeah, because it seemed like, you know, when she would pray over their bodies or whatever, nothing really happened. I was expecting more visual.
There's no
visual,
buffs or anything.
Yeah, more visual representation. Like, they just faded away.
It's not one of those type of things.
I know it's not, but it's like, they really hitting it home. Oh, just pray every time. Every time? Every time I fight somebody, you pray every time.
Man, don't they have priests in firehouses?
Do they?
I was up there.
At least not to my knowledge that I've seen.
Nico's going to be a firefighter, so that's what we asked.
I always thought they had like a firefighter, like a priest that would just pray before they go out.
Can we not just pray ourselves? Let's stop everybody else.
Yeah, but I think
there could be like a chaplain that could also like a chaplain, there, but I don't believe it's mandated.
I know, because I do work for the government. There's always like a sheriff department. They have a chaplain, and they pray before they go out and all that stuff. It's just the men's focus is not on that, and that's the reason.
Mm. All right, and Nigos, it's your turn now.
So, I'm not going to be I just
the
lost
who knows
my
English.
I just lost my will to live. Thought on what?
Let him talk.
It's going to take longer if you don't let him talk.
Exactly.
I'm not going to beat down the dead horse much more. So, one of the parts I didn't really like, and this is coming more from my experience with going through Fire Academy and that, is the outfit design. Like, it was pretty cool, but just through my training in that, it does nothing for protecting them against the fire.
He walked around barefooted.
He can walk up fire, produce fire.
Like, there's only one guy in there that had, like, full protection, then only the nun had the respirator on to be able to breathe.
True.
And my mind was just going, like, there are so many byproducts from that fire in there. Like, they would be suffocating.
He's so technical.
Because that's what I literally just finished my Fire Academy training, like, a couple months ago. And this is refreshing my mom. Just say, I can't get that out of my head.
You're over here like, hey,
you know y'all dead, right?
All right.
But one thing I do like is that kind of the uniqueness a bit of the enemies, the spontaneous human combustion. Mm-hmm. I don't think we've really ever seen that in any other anime read in manga or anything. So that was pretty unique. Like, that threw me off a little bit. I didn't know that they'd actually, like, through all the trailers and that, I didn't think that they were fighting, like, actual people that just combusted. I thought it was just, like, a fire demon came out and they have to go and fight it.
And they all seem to be unique too.
Yeah. All different looking.
And then one thing I hope for is like to figure out what that like King Infernal was, just whatever he saw. Get like the story on that.
Yeah.
Or why Infernals happen.
Gotcha. So
excuse me.
No problem. The thing that I like the most about the show so far, is actually his fighting style, because I ain't never seen anything like
just
that.
Just from all feet.
Yeah, because you're used to like punching or swords or something very much like that, and this guy's just going
he
in
got
like
that shoe style.
Yeah, he got that shoe. He's got that rocket fire bending shoe style
mixed with
Zuko.
Oh yeah, he's Bakugo mixed with like Deku or something,
and
mixed with Zuko.
Yeah, so Zuko.
That's dope.
That's the thing. Look, because we've seen firebending where they've done that.
Yeah,
like they're doing very similar things in Avatar, and I'm looking at this, I'm like, I don't know too many animes that actually have the main character kicking like this. This is really interesting, the way he moves around and everything. I love that.
Yeah, that's pretty dope.
My least favorite part right now is, I would say actually the content of the fight. The fight seemed too quick.
Yeah. Mm.
Like, they were quality, and I liked what I saw when I saw it, but I want to see more.
You kill both the enemies in like
one shot.
Days.
Yeah.
And that pile bunker kill was nice, though.
Yeah.
I love pile bunkers.
I love that when they do anime.
So, and that's actually what I want to see more of in the future. I want to see more of the other characters, like the captain. Mm-hmm. He's going in there just punching things with a pile bunker. I want to know what's up with him.
Yeah.
Who is this insane man who is all about just punching fire demons in the chest and blowing them apart?
Right.
Please ignore that sound in the background. Nico's causing problems.
I think that's you.
No, that's Brian's phone.
Oh.
That's not even, what is that?
Anyways, I want to see more about the team, their backstories, and what they're capable of going forward, you know?
Right.
Because they seem interesting to me. Please turn that off. Jesus.
And he's asking
nothing. We can complain about them later.
Jesus.
Oh my God. But yeah, so Brian, like I was saying, I want to see more about the team because they all seem unique and actually interesting as far as a team goes. Like that glasses go, he's got some kind of vendetta grudge stuff going on.
Yeah.
The cap, it's exactly who I think it is, isn't it?
Just keep going.
Okay. But yeah, Captain, he's the main one I want to see more about. Just this insane dude going around punching fire demons in the chest.
And popping ice or whatever it was.
It's a spike.
Oh, it's a spike.
It's a pile bunker.
Oh.
Yeah. They straight up said, like, he's just using a pile bunker. I'm like, this dude's insane.
And that was also the only one that had, like,
the full gear, yeah.
Protection.
Oh, yeah. Only smart guy.
Yeah. Sure. So, yeah. That's my thing. Like, we've seen there's characters there, and I want to see more of them. They seem interesting, and I want to know their details. I want to see them fight a little more, too, get their moment in there. Because this episode was definitely about Shinra. Like, they all stepped aside when he started, like, saying, oh, it's my turn.
Yeah.
And they powered up, and they all watched him. That's what I'm
saying. Like, they make it seem like he's the guy. It's supposed to be the team.
Right. That's the thing. I want to see more team. Yeah. As far as the show goes overall, I do think it's worth watching. Like, don't get our criticisms wrong. We're trying to be fair. But personally, I think it's worth watching. I think it's going to be interesting to see how the story develops.
Yeah. I was just going to say a little disclaimer.
Go ahead and say your disclaimer now.
My only disclaimer is, you know, take this with a grain of salt. It is the first episode of a new series. Usually new series are lacking in the first episode. That's just
how I don't know. My Hero got me right away.
My Hero did not get me.
No,
right
I hated My Hero.
Yes.
First. I hated My Hero like the whole first season.
Y'all love it.
And I love it now. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, so take it with a grain of salt. I'm pretty sure as we go on, you'll get a clear picture of what this anime has to offer.
Thank you all for watching. We'll see you all next time.
Peace.